Hello and welcome back to the Geoffrey Gardens, which is the very last park in the Corkscrew Follies expansion pack. Now, the weather has been cloudy, but it's turning sunny in great contrast to how the weather is over here, because, yeah, currently it's howling with rain, wind and thunder as the remnants of Hurricane Gonzalez are charging over the country here. But that's of little importance, as the weather here is good. The park is blooming. Well, actually, it still has to bloom. It only has 4 guests in the park, so to say that we're doing great... Oh well, I'm sure it will come. One thing to make this park be a little bit greater than it already is to have a coaster, and that is going to be one of the top priorities. Now, I've had a thought about this. There are 2 ways to deal with this, and if we open up our rides window over here, and we go to our coasters, there's 2 strategies we could go with. We could choose the Virginia Reel because it's cheap. But, downside, it only has tubs. That's it. You know, that's 4 guests max. Same for that one. And it's even worse over here where there can only be 2 folks in it. All of those are cheap. All of them won't generate crap loads of money. Now, I see this, you know, in a light of like, invest early now, make big bucks early on, it will repay itself tenfold. So what I think we should go for is this one. If we need to, take out some more loan, but at least try and get a coaster that's really compact, really cheap. Average ratings, so I'm not, well, of course if I can get it, 8 in the ratings, but it has to be compact and cheap, so most likely it'll be around a 6 and a 5 and a 6 or something, you know, for the 3 rating categories. So this is what we're going to be aiming for, a mediocre coaster right at the start. I think the wooden one is also the best suited for it because... Well, I'm not really sure, but I hope that if we research coasters, we get its twin brother, you know, its cloned brother with a few extra gimmicks, basically. So, yeah, this one's perfect to just make a mediocre coaster out of, and the rest can all be awesome. And the next coaster could be on a budget, you know, because this is probably going to cost us a lot of money. So the next coaster, we need to have it cheap. So because, well, it will cost a lot of money. We'll probably be out of money by the time we'll build this next coaster. So that needs to be cheap. But this one, yeah, this is going to be the one. Now, seeing how space is at a premium, and yeah. It might not be that apparent, but space really is the premium. We need to have this coaster be around this area. I wanted to hook up to this piece of the straight section somewhere. We're not going to have anything hook up over here. This is just going to be straight walkways. We are going to have stuff hooking up over here. Not over here. That's just no. That's a big no. So that ain't going to happen, but... Yeah, the coaster needs to be over here. Now, what I'm thinking of doing is building a station underground, like right below the center of the trifectum, the triflesium. Oh, I should have named it like that. Well, I'm gonna keep it. But yeah, that's what I'm thinking of doing. That way we'll have some underground sections. We can probably do like a few ups and downs, a few curves, go into the underground and then return to the station. Now, having said that, it's probably going to be a above ground return to the station. Now, well, we'll see. For now, I think we should get this built. So this will be the entry point into the underground, and I think that we're actually going to leave the lead up tracks for whatever they are, really. Look, like this, we just start out with a straight track, which is also what I'm aiming for. Right, so we are actually not going to remove any tracks over here, alright? We're gonna keep them as they are. I could lower this perhaps a little bit, but I'm not going to. Though, having said that, Now we'll actually have to lower it a little bit. That is purely to fit in an entrance and exit. I don't really want to lower it too much. I think the exit is fine right now. We'll have to see if I can fit this. No, right, good. Yeah, okay, now the bad thing is, where was it we were building? Oh, right over there. So how far does this go? Ooh, the station platform is to loom right on this very end. That's perfect. That's brilliant. That really is good. Now, of course, we're going to have an entrance over here then. That ain't going to fit right now. Yeah, I could have guessed that. Look, this is going to be the entrance there. That is a fact. There is no way around this. You know what? Instead of going up the traditional way, why don't we do it, you know, a bit of out of whack. Not traditional, is what I mean with that. That ain't gonna work because we need to raise a little of the land. I do believe though, yeah, it's not much. That is exactly... Oh, this is perfect. Look, minimal amounts of terraforming, but a very interesting start already. This is very good. Now, what isn't good is the fact that our guests, currently, they don't really have that much to do over here. But... Oh, that's really bad. Well, there is a way to deal with that. That would be like this. We still need to have this go up, of course. And let's see. Right, that works. Now, I don't really want this to go too high. We need to be on a budget. High coasters are not good for the budget, just so you know. Pro tip from a pro tycoon here. I also think that we're gonna need this to be like this. We need an on-ride photo section. That's a guarantee. Also, pro tip from a pro tycoon. Take the on-ride photo section. Now, we don't have a helix down, which is a shame. I also think that going underground right now already and then thinking about curling back might be a little bit too early on, so we won't do that either. Instead, we're gonna try and see if we can get away with these. No. Why not? Oh yeah, I see why not. Right, so we'll have to do it like this then. And of course the bloody tree is in the way. Could have figured that one out myself. Look. And the lift will take care of pretty much everything. Now what we're gonna do... I wish I could have this go on the ground, but I look at my cache and I see... Now right, fine. We're gonna go underground with it. Fine. We'll do it. Okay. Well, maybe not actually. I would love to go underground, but I don't think it's gonna happen. No, we won't. I mean, wherever the station leads to, that's pretty much, you know, or wherever the... Well, the thing is, this is the track that we need to hook it up to. And that's where we're gonna go for right now, looking at our cache. So... And that is gonna be too high. So I guess that would be alright when it comes to speed. Now, how are we doing in terms of lining this whole shenanigan up? This is actually on the money, this. In terms of height, at least. Now, of course, we don't really want just a... Oh, no, you gotta be kidding me. It hooks up! Nice! Very tight and compact coaster. I'm very much looking forward to whatever the test results will be. I don't think it will be that extreme, though the underground sections... I wish we could have had better and bigger ones, but wow, you know, that's just it. For this budget, that's it. We could not have had any more. Right then, fine. That's what it's gonna be like with the path. I accept that. We would need to go across over there, and then up, like this. I don't really want too much sky paths, so to say. So we're gonna keep them as close to the terrain as possible. Then, over here, This is gonna... No. That's gonna be more of a challenge, this one.
Yeah.
Most definitely. Yeah. Derp. Big derp there. Right. Now, hold on a second. Before we move on, because... Yeah. We don't have ratings yet. That's... Well, that's good and it isn't. But we are gonna close it, so the ratings will have to wait for a little bit longer. Because, well, that was a bit of a small oversight on my end. We're gonna test that again, just so that we can get some ratings at some point, but... Yeah, I should have foreseen that, really. No, I didn't. No, nobody's perfect, I guess. Right, now, if we go... Oh, right now we're... Alright, so if I go straight there then, and I just terraform that piece, and I try to go up here, well, we're only looking at the path right now. I try to keep those, you know, those odd looking hills at a minimum, but, oh well. And that hooks it up, alright. That is not really ideal. Wow, and if you could hear that, by the way, that was some thunder. What? We don't have enough cash for this? Oh no. This is really bad. Oh man, yeah, hold on a second. This is really, really bad. We need more money right now. Not gonna take out everything, but wow. Yeah, I know it can only be built across paths. That was exactly the point in game. Right, well, we've seen the test run of this. I don't... Oh no, it is too extreme. We missed it. However, if we can lower the intensity by just a eeny weeny bit, and my feeling is that it's over here, this intensity, because the vertical G's seem about right, lateral G's seem to be a bit on the high end. And is it in the latter part? I don't think it is, actually. It seems to be more over here. And hold on a second. Altitude? Velocity? Really high. Lateral G spike? Also really high. I don't really know where this is, in all honesty. Where's train 1? Train 1's heading right there, right now. So, if train 1's over there, then this is not the G spike that we're looking at. That G spike comes later, and it is right over here. This is the piece that is not good. We need to fix this, and we are going to. That curve there, that is the one causing havoc for our track design. That's no biggie, really. We can deal with it, like we always do. And then like this, and then like this. Oh, I think we might even still be one off. But not anymore right now. Look at this. You know what? We'll actually make it wonky. Yeah, that should improve the ratings quite a bit. So what we'll do is we'll quickly set this up and we'll just open it up. I mean, one train will be doing a test ride right now. The other trains will be docked at the station for guests to just hop on. So we should be all good, really. We'll open it up. Look, see, first train is still departing. Second train should now remain at the station. Very important. And this should start generating us lots of money. Now, where are we? We're still at the... Well, we're almost halfway through April and we got a coaster and two rides. Granted, I didn't... Well, I kept it within the budget, but only barely. So, I wouldn't say that financially speaking, this was the best thing we ever did. But we did it and it's there now, so... Now also, in terms of, like, park expansion. Well, actually, let's finish this coaster first, shall we? Let's worry about that later. Let's not get ahead of ourselves, really. We are going to call this, plunger. There. It does plunge quite a few times into the unknown, really. Can we change... You could change that backwards. I think I did that once actually, and all it really does is just up the intensity rating a little bit. And besides, we would need to close that once again, and we're not going to. So instead, hey, wait. Yeah. The illusion of choice once again. Oh man. Yeah, we just need to give this paint job and then we're golden. Now this is of course a garden park, but we are gonna go classic yet unexpected color combinations. I feel that that would be a great choice over here. I'm not really happy about the support colors. Let's try something else. I quite like how this gives a vibe. If I now that's that makes it look like candy, but this has some kind of vibe to it, you know. I don't know. It's odd. It's offbeat yet not that ugly yet not commonly seen in our parks. I don't know really. It has an appeal to me, and that's enough. At least enough for me to keep it. Then we are, of course, going to be this isn't classy. We're going to go with a velvet red. That is classy. Yeah, white and velvet red. Classy, you know, a bit of odd colors, and then the trains being classy. Yeah, I like this. Alright, that's opened up. Now, the stuff. That needs also be set up. We already put one bench there. That's all we can do, so... also, we already have a handy dude here. However, I do feel that because this is a coaster, we'll hire another one. Like you, you'll patrol over there. This area is for the other handy dude. This one will have that area. And we are going to need a safety mechanic. You'll be dropped right there. And you'll have that very area to worry for, and you'll only be fixing rides. Now, it's only a 10-minute inspection time, but with only 3 rides quite close here, this one mechanic will do. So we won't change anything there just yet. And this is pretty much fixed. Now, I must admit, I'm quite happy with how it looks, and the fact that the supports aren't completely hiding everything, so... There's no curtain of supports being just closed. Now it is time for the next phase of the park's expansion. So let's take a quick gander at what we can build. What I'm thinking of doing really is building another gentle ride over here. Right on top of there. What do we have that would fit there quite beautifully? Isn't this just a true and proper coincidence? I see a ride that fits perfectly over here. You know how we are going to fit this in over here? Oh yeah, I got it all planned out. Look, this is gonna be right on top over there. It only needs a one big queue tile line anyway, and then the exit can be right over here, leading just around it. Oh, that's totally how it's gonna be. Look, perfect setup. I don't want a long queue on this one. Long queues always do bad on these crappy rides anyway. Well, the crap wheel. I mean, I call that like that for a reason, which by now I don't need to explain anymore, I think. We all know why it's bad, and we all know what... No, that I wanted the button above there. Anyway, we all know why it's bad, we all know why we still need to build it. Also, over here, we'll build you, there. Right, that's that taken care of. Now, do we have the ratings? Look at that. Look at that. I aimed for a sixer, and that is exactly what we got. Not the most expensive coaster, not the cheapest one either. I have built them cheaper and more compact. But pretty compact, pretty cheap for a wooden coaster. I've built them, lots of them, a lot more expensive. So yeah, this is good. This is a good medium coaster. It doesn't have really high intensity, so this is good for ramping stuff up. I approve. I mightily approve. We also have 137 guests in the park, but some of them are already leaving. You don't really have anything to do there. Yeah, but that's because we didn't really have a proper coaster. Now that we do have one, look, the guests are just flocking on it. Right, nice. Okay, this then. Oh, well, it's so bad in comparison to this awesome coaster. We will charge $5 for you. Yes, looking at that. Wow, and I mean, we have 3 years in the... Well, pretty much almost 4 years still ahead of us, but already I feel the pressure mounting. For some reason, I still feel, or I already feel, that I'm behind, you know? That I needed to have more guests in the park. Even though it's not really realistic, I mean, if this trend continues, then in May or in June, we'd have enough guests in the park for the first year, but still. I don't know, it's just, I keep feeling the pressure. That's how we're gonna call this, you know? We're gonna call this, we're gonna call this the controller rad. Wow. Alright. Now, this can have, No. It does need to be black. Then this can be red, yes, and this can be white. Or could it be the same yellow? I don't know, this bar, so far there's all, every ride that we got has a touch of red in it. I don't really mind keeping that tradition for this area, for this first area, as long as we mix it up later. I guess. Alright. That's also odd. Usually I keep lots of variety. We'll change things up a bit, you know? I'm all for doing things different than I've done before, so that is also like a bit of a finale to this park, you know, doing things differently. Right, that's good then. For this one I won't add another handy dude because I don't really feel it's needed. Then over here we need another thrill ride. Do we have a new... Oh, wow, we have a dome. The dome. Look at my dome. My dome is amazing. man, now I'm so seeing the pictures of that horrible YouTube movie that came with that song. Anyway, we're gonna build the ship. I could try and build that over here near the water side, but I really feel that the water side is reserved for water rides. We have plenty of water over here. You know what? What we could do, really, thinking about it, what we could do is just build water rides here and here over the river. I don't see why we wouldn't, really. So the ship is going to be up on the hill. It's a stranded ship. What I'm thinking of doing here, I mean, I'll, park expansion planning. We have one ride over here. We'll then have another one over here, and, well, we are going to have another ride over here, but that's not going to hook up to this main path, you know, we need to spread that out a little bit, and what I'm thinking of doing is, because most of the rides are over here, we need to keep it compact, we're going to build a couple more rides over here that are going to hook up to this one. I don't know if you can see it proper. But these paths over here, you know, the ones over here. So I want that section to be open up, so we'll probably cut that off. But that's for later. Let's first get the ship in there. Now, there's two ways to position this. This is one of them. But I think that this is the proper position, right? There's no front or back end to this one, so yeah, that's how it's gonna be. Right on... What? No, there is no tree. Never saw one. There never was one. That's how it works. So we're gonna have the entrance there. Exit there. With a tree right in front of it. Oh, man. Surprised? No, not really. Anyway, see, I kind of want to keep that bridge intact. I don't really want too many things leading to and from that bridge. I think this is the bridge over the river damage. The river Dwy. By the way, I mean, totally off topic, but I recently saw a Top Gear episode about that river quite, which was hilarious. I mean, if that gets aired again, definitely record it and watch it. That's hilarious. Anyway, yeah, this is gonna be the ship that crossed the river Dwy, you know? Not Kwai, but Dwy, with the D from damage. Yes. Now, this is a proper queue, I feel, for this ride, so let's quickly go about set that up there. You are gonna be 25, because you'll be popular till the end of days. Well, maybe not till the end of the fourth year, but a good way in the third year, you'll still be popular. So yeah, max pricing 5, magic formula. Now, we're gonna call this the ship cross the river Dwy. I don't know if this will fit. Wait, what? Oh, no, the ship across the river. Alright, well, that's good. That's good enough as well. we'll just have to keep Dwy in mind. Alright, the ship, maybe I can, I mean, nah, without, you know, both those the words, it looks just odd, you know, it looks like a statement. Ship, like a newspaper heading, you know, like, yeah, no, not gonna happen, not like that. Right, well, we need to give this a color spray then. So what I'm thinking is, you know, in tradition with the red that we're trying to keep here, we could then give this a more of an icy blue. It gives for nice contrast, really. Perhaps, I don't know, we'll go with this because it's more softer, you know, and this is a park as well. I think those hard and icy blues that I've gone with in several parks, you know, like Aqua World and other parks, you know, I think we're gonna leave those out quite a bit in this one. It's gonna be looking like none of the parks have looked before. Okay, that's no, this is gonna be grass colored as far as we can get it. That's, yeah, well, I mean, which one fits the most? Definitely not that one. It's one of those two, really, or, yeah, definitely. I think this is the one that fits the best, in all honesty. This one doesn't really, so yeah, it's gonna be that one. And then those beams will make those white. Okay, we won't. I mean, that easy. yeah, I guess we could make, no, we can't make that green. Light, no. Black, I guess that is what it was. I mean, these supports are also black. We'll keep those triangular supports black, you know, fits in well with the other ride here. Just a different color spray. Yeah, alright, that's cool. Now, because of this ride being right here, right now, we are going to need a new entry sign and a handy dude here. Right now it's warranted, so we'll get that. And I also think that right now is the moment that we need a second loose mechanic, because with the rides over here and over here, just one mechanic isn't gonna cut it, really, in my eyes. And we will, wait, haven't I just hired one of you, or were you just walking over there already? I guess the latter, actually, because I think we hired a mechanic. Yeah, we did. Right, that will be your area to keep clean. No, not that one over there. This is enough. Yeah, it really is. Actually, all you'd need is this area to keep that exit clean. No, that, even that isn't really needed, but ah well. Right, good, good. This is right now looking very good. I think, yeah, look at this. See, guests are going everywhere and there's hardly anyone leaving because there's always something to do. And you know what's even better? Each and every one of these trains can have 28 people on them, I believe. I mean, it's 4 passengers, yeah. 28 times 3 with a very short ride time, I mean, only 48 seconds. That means that there won't ever be a queue for this ride. Well, unless it's raining, of course, but So, yeah, this is our profit, money, we're getting it, nice. And what are we gonna do with it? Well, you'll find that out next time when we play more Rollercoaster Tycoon.